Well, back here in Memphis this week, city council members will decide on spending $175 million on a massive makeover for the Cook Convention Center.
Council members Martavius Jones and Worth Morgan joining us here this morning to tell us more about where we stand, or at least what the rumor is as far as what's the latest.
With the Cook Convention Center, it's a bond issue we're voting on?
Right, so we don't have $170 million
right.
sitting in the bank.
I can contribute a little bit, but not that much.
Yeah, here's the money for the convention center.
So how does it work? So you'll be voting on municipal bonds, selling?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Is it expected to pass?
Well, tourism is such a major economic driver here. When you talk about Nashville spent $1 billion on theirs, you know, we still have to spend this just to be competitive.
Yeah, and from the discussion we've had, you know, thus far, there have been a lot of questions. We do our due diligence on it, but I don't think so much controversy. I think we know we need this. We have a dedicated revenue stream to pay for these bonds. And the number of $100 million projects in Memphis, you can basically count on your hands. This is a big deal and a big step for the city to try to remain competitive with the other cities in Nashville that also have large convention centers.
Yeah, I haven't heard a whole lot against it from citizens, from politicians. I mean, so it's pretty much a done deal in your estimation.
I would estimate, yes.
Yeah, I think there's still some more details to come in terms of having a, you know, upgraded or new hotel connected to the convention center. And that, you know, involves more private development and some other changes that might come downtown to coincide with the city making this investment. So that's really what I would be looking for in the future. We're going to put the money in. Let's see who comes alongside us and partners on the private side.
What else is like top on your priority list when you sit down and you start trying to hammer things out again? Do you have something that is like on the top of your list that says we're going to be talking about this today?
Yeah, the list is too long.
Okay, what are the top things on your list?
No. Well, personally for me in my district, we've got a lot of zoning cases coming that will be controversial and we'll have some opposition to them. So I look forward to a land use control board meeting this week, as well as two votes that we have tomorrow, including the Cooper Young historic neighborhood district, and we'll be voting on that. And while Cooper Young isn't in my neighborhood, Midtown and a lot of the neighborhoods that I do represent feel very strongly about the historic neighborhoods that they are in, and so they always look towards.
Yeah, I saw that on the agenda. Frankly, I thought Cooper Young already had historic designation. It doesn't?
It has historic designation as far as, you know, just the general neighborhood, but as it relates to the requirements when it comes to the future development. So let's say somebody wants to come in and raise three or four houses. Well, there's nothing in place that prevents that from taking place right now.
I
guess the designation that Cooper Young currently has doesn't necessarily come.
Doesn't go far enough.
Correct.
Well, let's talk about last Thursday. You had a joint city-county meeting. What was that about?
Well, we talked about a number of different issues. The first time, as I understand, that the city council and the county commission has met in, well, since 2010.
Right.
So a couple of things that we talked about. We talked about pre-K. We talked about pretty much the workforce development edge. Those are just three of the four topics that we talked about.
Why is it important to come together with them? Because it was kind of surprising to me that it hadn't happened in so long.
Yeah, I was surprised. Well, I think they said since 2010 or something along those lines.
8 years.
And it you know, it was a couple hours out of one afternoon. I think it was important for all of us just to get in front of each other and realize a lot of times and even y'all report on it, sometimes there's some bickering back and forth where one side of government will kind of be starting to argue with the other.
We hear it a lot here.
And to realize that we are on the same page on so many things, especially workforce development, economic development, where we do have to partner. Because if a company is going to come to Memphis or Shelby County and get tax breaks, that's tax breaks as related to city property taxes and county taxes. And we have to be on the same page, I think, in how we want to be able to compete for businesses.
Maybe agree not to wait 8 more years before your next opportunity.
It was an easy and it was a good meeting.
There are some big issues that always create a little angst, education being one of them. There are many on the county side who feel like Memphis shouldn't have gotten out of the education business still. The sewer issue, was any of that brought up?
The sewer issue didn't come up, but the education piece came up.
I let Martavius take the education.
And the comment was made, well, Memphis is the only municipality that's not contributing to education.
Right.
But I pulled up Bartlett's budget. They have a $78 million budget. Municipal taxes only paid $3 million of it. $30 million comes from the county, but 60% of the counties comes from Memphis. So I refute anybody's assertion that Memphis is not paying for education, because we are the majority of Shelby County.
The largest group in
when
the county.
When we pay taxes, and that goes to education, we pay for everybody.
Did you make any headway in that argument?
Well, I feel that we have a representation on the Shelby County Commission that understands that now. I don't think they have in the past.
Okay.
There have been assertions that it's Shelby County, then it's Memphis.
Right.
As if Memphis is not part of Shelby County.
Right.
So I think
right.
that you have Shelby County commissioners that understand that.
Okay. Yeah. Then it sounds like the meeting was time well spent.
Yes, we need to do it.
If only on that
there
point.
Were a few hot button topics, but it didn't get out of control.
Good to